Hi, so today we're going to look at KKBOX music recommendation system which we have built. So we have included all the steps from pre-processing to the final recommendation of songs. This project is done by Abhishek Sarvepalli, Freya Genesis and myself. So to look at the problem statement first, we could see that KKBOX is Asia's leading music streaming service, and also it holds around 40 million different tracks. And so we can also see that this is mostly related to the South Asian market of music. So we're going to build a recommendation system based on the top set of features we get from feature extraction, and we're going to predict the list of top tracks for each particular user and also for a new user. So initially talking about general problems which everyone would face in recommendation system. So one main problem would be a cold start problem, where there is large amount of data required for making very accurate recommendations. So if a new user starts using the app, so we don't have any other information apart from the demographics of the user, which will lead us to very not so accurate recommendations. So once the user starts using the app, and henceforth more data is created from the user, we will be able to give more accurate recommendations and more personalized recommendations to this particular user. Second problem one would face is the long tail problem, where in the event of big data, we have like more number of users coming in place, and also like the number of songs in this particular case to be in millions. So to get and calculate probabilities of a particular user listening to a particular song will be very, very minute, and this scale has to be taken care of. And coming to the next step, so because of the huge data available, the matrix which we're going to build to find the recommendations is going to be very sparse, because every user is not going to listen to every song. So we would be having a sparse matrix here. So one should take care of the sparse matrix too. Also, coming up with the next part, where we would talk about the different kinds of recommender systems, where there are collaborative methods and then content-based methods. And to improve the accuracy, people have also combined both of them to give better kind of results. So to look at each one of them, so collaborative filtering is when there are similar users who have same likes and same interests. So we could use their information together to recommend him or her to a particular item, or in our case, a particular song. So content-based filtering here is the likes and dislikes of one particular user. So if a user has listened to a set of songs by a particular artist, then we would recommend him to re-listen these kind of songs because he has listened to them before. So next we're going to talk about the EDA which we have done on the entire data set. So this is going to be I would give it back to Abhishek and Freya to continue from here.
Hi, we'll talk about the experimental data analysis we did for our project before we could move on to any other building recommendation system. So we wanted to create a data storyline. So we'll first look at the data schema. We want to know how our data looks. So here we look at the different correlation between the feature variables we have in our data training data set. Here we see that the city and the age are positively correlated. Next, we'll look at the various null values in our data set. Here we see that the lyricist and gender make up for the majority of the null values in our data set. Next, we look at the source type distribution coming from our data sets. Here we can see that most of the users, which majority of the users, fall into these three categories, and out of which two-thirds prefer listening to songs locally rather than any other source type. Next, we look at the relationship between the languages and various other metrics
like number of songs, popularity, and chances of it being replayed. We observe an almost similar distribution across the three features. And except for a particular language that comes under category minus 100, we don't see much variation.
Next, we'll look at the popularity of the genres. We see that the majority of the users prefer listening to these three genres, out of which most of them want to listen to the genre 465, which we intuitively think.
We feel that since this data set is from the Asian countries, it suggests the Asian pop culture, so probably this genre could be pop. This distribution is it explains a negative correlation between the number of artists and the number of plays. So number of plays is basically how popular a particular track is across the users per artist, and we see the distribution suggests that the majority of the artists have a very less number of plays, a lesser popularity across the users, and there are only a very small amount of users that have a majority number of plays. This plot is the number of artists versus the chances of the track being repeated. We see an equal amount of artists that have a chance of it, of their tracks being replayed or not. So there is a 50-50 chance of the artist being popular.
So here we look at the various songs, song names and artist names, which are very popular in our amongst our data set. So here we can see that the biggest name here.
We see the most common or the most popular artists among all the users, and we made a word cloud out of it. And similarly, for the most common phrases that were used in the song names, or the words that were used in the song names, we prepared a word cloud out of it.
So here we have to talk about the most important, we need to identify the most important variable from our training data set. Hence, we do some feature extraction where we'll identify the most important variables. So how do we start? So we take the data, we pre-process the data, we take the pre-processed data and fit it in a LightGBM model to identify the most important variable.
So since it was discussed in the previous slides about not considering target variable, as it only considered the number of play counts and how often the user will repeat the particular track, so we wanted to take portions or weightings of all the other features. Hence, we plotted a variable importance plot by using the model LightGBM. In this plot, it gave us results such as the registration year to be the most influential influential feature. The inference from this says that if a user has registered recently, he is more probable to listen to more number of tracks than a user that was registered previously, an old user. The next comes to the recommendation system.
We'll talk about how we model a recommendation system and how we plan to suggest users the similar kind of songs which he would like. From now on, Vinil will take
So once we have got the new set of features which we think are important for our recommendation system, we would like to look at, from this particular point, we would like to look at in two different parts where either we have a new user or a personalized user. For a new user, as mentioned, we would look at the most famous and most popular, most trending songs. Because he would, we don't have much information from him. So for a personalized user, we have chosen this path where, with respect to the user, we calculate across different metrics which we find are important from the feature importance plot, and we understand that we take the user counts with respect to artists, languages, and different other variables. So from that, we normalize the data with respect to the maximum counts which we have in the entire data set, so that each feature is comparable to the other. Then, using this particular normalized value, we rank them according to their scores, and from these rankings, we will be able to get the artist-artist similarity and genre similarity to understand for this particular artist who are the most recommended artists. So using these artist information and genre information, we would like to see the set of songs which relate to these particular combinations. And for this particular user, the set of songs coming out from the linear combination would be our recommendations. So to deep dive and then see, we have shown the artist similarity. It is done using the TF-IDF model, where for across the universe artist, we have seen that these are the comparison of similarity with respect to this particular artist. Similarly, we have also seen genre similarity and language similarity. So once we have all the similarities, we would like to look at the final results, where we would show which are the set of songs which are recommended to a particular user. So here we're going to talk about how a new user is going to be recommended. So we, for a new user, we would show the most famous and most trending songs which he can listen to initially. And then once we procure more data from this particular user, we would be able to give him personalized recommendations. So here, we are taking a five-step approach, where initially, we're going to look at user and artist, where for this particular user, who has already listened to this set of artists, we want to predict who are the new set of artists which the user is most likely to listen and like the songs. So here, according to the model, these are the set of artists which are mostly related to these set of users, this set of artists. And to get the user and genre information, here for the same user, he has listened to mainly only to one kind of genre. So from the model, we understand which are the other genres which are closely related to this set of genres. And also, we get the same kind of information for composers. Now, from the entire data set, we get the maximum counts so that we can normalize these set of counts and give ranking according to their. So here, if we see, we would get a rank. And then from that rank, we can rank artist or composer or genre as priority. So next, we take for different linear combinations of artist, genre, and we try to see which are the set of songs which belong to these artists and language. So here, for the same particular user, we're gonna recommend these are the set of songs which are most likely he's going to listen to. So in the future scope, So for this project, primarily we can use NLP to get the information text which the user searches in the search term for in the app. So this will help us to get the latest trends of songs, and if there are few set of songs which KKBOX doesn't previously have, they could include it into their entire database. And also audio models, where we could use deep learning models to understand and get the set of songs which are closely related to the other songs in terms of frequency.
The next 2 points in our future scope is implementing tensors. So till now, our model, our recommendation system, had only considered vectors, which made the model static. So the most latest techniques would be to use tensor factorization, which helps us build models that are more contextually aware and critically driven, which is just contextual filtering, and produces results that are more accurate and situational. And the last one in our future scope is an extension of the point which we used earlier, audio models, extending deep learning and reinforcement learning into the recommendation model would produce, again, a higher gamma value result.
So thank you. If you have any more questions, you could reach out to us to this set of emails. Thank you.
Thank you.